Hello. Today we are going to make United States of America flag. To make each row inflate balloons leaving no more than 1.5 inch flat tail. To make this flag we're going to use the same technique, work in the same fashion as described in previously published instruction fabric 9 flags 4. We have to prepare 6 white pairs, 7 red pairs and 7 blue pairs of balloons. Inflate 10 clear color connection balloons leaving about 5 inch flat tails. We're going to make 13 rows the size of almost fully inflated balloon. We can work the sculpture in either direction, from left, right, top, bottom. I personally prefer to work from left bottom side. In this example I will work from top left side. We are going to twist all bubbles, large sized bubbles, in each row of the same about 8-9 inch size. And we will lock the bubbles with clear color connection balloons. We are going to use 5 bubbles to make each side of the row. 4 large sized bubbles and the fifth is a short bubble, half size of the large bubble. Here we have to cut off the rest of the blue balloons. So in this example we're going to use 7 pairs of blue balloons to make 2 large bubbles along a rectangular shape in a left top corner of the flag. I'm going to first play next part of the video. Attach a pair of red balloons to finish this row. So actually we use 2 pairs of balloons to make each of the first top 7 rows of the flag. And we're going to use just 1 pair of balloons to twist each of the bottom 6 rows of the flag. Alright, we have made 4 large and 1 short bubble of the first row. Okay, cut off the rest of the red balloons. Start the second row from the left side, making the short bubble. Then we twist 1 large and then 1 short blue bubble. Cut off the rest of the blue balloons. Attach a pair of white balloons. Now again we twist short white bubbles and the rest of the row we work making large white bubbles. We have made the second row. Cut off the rest of the white balloons. We're going to work the next 5 rows in exactly the same fashion. I just turned the sculpture upside down for my convenience and also to avoid touching floor with balloons when I twist the balloon. For the same reason, it's actually better to walk around the sculpture twisting the bubbles than as I'm shown here, moving the large sculpture around myself. Because I'm moving the sculpture, I may pop some bubbles accidentally. In this example, I start twisting the sculpture from the top row. However, I think this particular sculpture is better to start from the bottom row. This way you will have better visual guidelines of what size bubbles you have to twist. Well, anyway, I'm just going to twist the way I already started, from the top row going down. The size of bubbles we twist is always important, of course, and so is the number of bubbles of each color. We twist 2 blue large size bubbles and we twist 2 large and 1 short red bubbles. I think it is the closest proportion that we can get using this fabric to represent American flag. Of course, you don't have to always follow the same proportions. There is no strict rules about it. There are ways to make American flag with less or more balloons. However, it's really near impossible, I think, to use less balloons and keep the same proportions of American flag. With more balloons, it's much easier to preserve the same proportions. All right, we have made the top 7 rows, and now it's going to be much easier. We have to make the bottom 6 rows. It is easier and faster because we're using just one pair of balloons to make entire row. In this example, I have made a mistake, unfortunately. I have made a mistake that I actually warn you about. Well, I'm just going to make the 6 bottom rows of a bit shorter size than the top 7 rows. It wouldn't happen if I started the sculpture from the bottom row. Of course, it is not a big deal. Even now, it's quite easy to fix. Just add a new pair of balloons to make all rows of the same size. It is very simple, so I'm not going to waste your time and balloons on fixing this mistake. Time. Well, working on large size sculptures is always time consuming process. Okay, we have made 13 rows. Now let's cut off the rest of the balloons, tie off the ends and hide them between bubbles. We can use the scissors to cut off balloons or do it with your fingers. And finally, we're getting closer to the stars. American flag is supposed to have 50 white stars. There are different ways to make stars. We can use white balloon to make very small size 5 petals flower to represent a star. In our example, I'm going to paint all 50 stars. And I'm going to paint with correction liquid or correction fluid. You can get it from office supply stores. I actually borrowed from my kids' school supplies. Drawing star is not difficult. First of all, I mark all 50 spots where I want to draw the stars. Be very careful using the correction liquid. Once you paint in wrong spot, for example, like this, it is really hard to remove. This correction liquid dries out fast, and a wet napkin cannot remove it. I would suggest to paint over the wrong spot with a blue marker. On American flag, stars arranged in rows. There are 5 rows of 6 stars and 4 rows of 5 stars. Once we mark all 50 spots, we proceed painting the stars. I actually use 2 cans of correction liquid here. It's actually much easier to paint the stars if you place the flag on a flat surface, on the floor or table. Pardon me for doing such a sloppy paintings. So you got the idea how to paint all 50 stars. There is something I want to say about correction liquid. Aga. We actually can use the correction liquid as a base paint. Once you paint with correction liquid, you let it dry out, and then you can paint over correction liquid with any other marker or any other color paint. It really works well on any color balloon, really well. Okay, here we have made all 50 stars. Congratulations! We have made flag of United States of America. Have fun and happy twisting!